we did actions and things that put us in prison. We already know that. We know that by the time we were arrested and handcuffed. And it's not three meals and a cotton, it's easy. Right? But like, there, you just know, and here you don't. And I have to like remind myself every time when I talk with my colleagues and my peers that they're not my adversaries. They're not trying to stab me literally in the back. Or they're not coming after my people. Or they're not trying, you know what I mean? Like, they're not sizing me up, or they're trying to neglect me or disrespect me. They respectfully try to ask me about something or honor me, try to get to know me. But where I'm from, like, that just doesn't happen. Or the ability to do these things. And it's hard. And the hardest thing is being able to, like, share that appropriate for so many versions and so many what if this and then this happened here and then in your mind and then your own demons and dreams and hopes and wishes. And it severely changed my life because that was my life. And living in there with all your senses just shut, because in the supermax in the north, you know, it's a severe harsh setting, because to really truly start to listen to myself and trust myself and validate myself, I didn't even know who I was then, and I'm beginning to understand who I am now. But it helped me just helped me realize that, one, that is, I don't have to be scared to ask for help or to say that I'm scared. It helped me to learn to read. Because I literally wrote every word in the dictionary and thesaurus. It helped me center myself and be at peace when I lived in an environment that's just severely chaotic. Because just because people are in supermax doesn't mean that things don't happen. And that's a hard question to answer, because what people don't know is solitary confinement just destroys a person. Because it's like you're dead, but you're alive. You're like a living ghost. You can't affect nobody, you know. But then another thing, the only thing it does is just makes you go into yourself. And however that struggle, you come out of that struggle, I just pray that the person is just sane, you know.
So what would you say would be like a good thing that came out of that?
Me? About it. So the north is, you just have your mattress and a blanket. They purposely keep the water freezing cold. They purposely don't let you have heat. I wrote like 900 songs and poems. I learned to read and information. That was the only thing that like probably saved me, was like knowledge, words and books, from gardening techniques to history of the Mayans to release from prison December 9th, 2013. And I actually finished my probation December 13th this year. And like, no one's yet ever asked me these questions. Well, at least like once every classroom, I throw up in the toilet, but still that doesn't mean that I'm not scared to death. Severe anxiety, you know, because like when you're in solitary confinement, you learn to exist with yourself, and you learn to like battle all this and that, and then your own imperfections.